then they will move on to the audit audit and audit tool enhancement, which we have given in release 3.6. So here we have kept this company open. This is National Traders 11-12. It's a current year company. We can look at here that this is auditor edition. So I hope you all might be aware of the fact that now from release 3.6 onwards, the auditor tool capabilities we have been extended to single user and multi user. But auditor edition will also be there. The product will be same. The auditor edition will be available to the auditor, that is practicing chartered accountants, at the same pricing policy, that is 80% discount, which is 10,800. So now, first of all, we'll start with the introductory part of revised Schedule 6. Schedule 6 was there since last 50 years, but this year, the Schedule 6 has been revised. So the point is, what was the need to revise it, and who has done it? All the companies who are registered ROC, that is Registrar of Companies, they will have to submit their financial statements in this format. It is as per Companies Act 1956. And why have they revised it? Reason being, because India, we know currently our country is going global. Because of this, they want their financial statements and everything should be in line with International Financial Reporting Standards, that is IFRS. So as to make the financial statements globally acceptable, they have provided this. So, see, earlier we were providing Schedule 6, now we are providing revised Schedule 6. So what different thing, what different user experience we want to provide to them? Earlier in Schedule 6, since last so many years, CAs were using Excel. Because in that, what facility they were getting, they need not to pass general vouchers from for any specific thing. And they can do copy paste easily. For that thing, it was not affecting their client's data too. So that is the same experience we have brought in release 3.6 UI Schedule 6. They need not to pass general entries. They can do the copy paste general move thing, and it also won't affect the default tally data of the client. Now we start with the capabilities which we have provided in the revised Schedule 6. Here, first of all, I'm getting down into profit and loss account. This is the general profit and loss account, which in for day-to-day business client maintain for their MIS purpose. Now, from this format, we have to prepare their revised Schedule 6. Means the figure should be same. The difference will be in format. So that is what the expectation is. For providing this, what we have given, you can see here alters, that is Schedule 6. I just click on a button. With this click of a button, the first draft of revised Schedule 6 format for profit and loss account is ready. I just repeat, it's a first draft in revised Schedule 6 format of the P&L account. The things which are coming at the left hand side, these are schedule heads. You can see in front of the schedule heads, figures are coming. So now the point of concern is from where these figures are coming. See, and these figures are coming because of the automatic mapping done by the tally. So whatever tally could map by default, that has been done, and tally understands that that this particular ledger should get into this particular schedule head. On that basis, this detail has been captured. See, on the same page, there might be something which may be capturing your attention. What can that be? You can see here something is coming in black, something is coming in red. So what are these? It's a general curiosity, why are these coming in red, or why are other things are coming in black? See, we drill down from them for just to see it. Why are these coming in red? I drill down from revenue from operations. Here you can see under revenue from operations, this is ungrouped revenue from operations. See, means whatever system could map, they map, and which system can't understand has not been properly configured by the user, fall under ungroup. And that ungroup, because this ungroup should be mapped into the proper schedule head. That's why it shouldn't left by the customer, it's coming in red. I just detail it out using Alt F1. Here you can see that these sales ledgers are coming in the sale of product, and these ledgers are coming in the sale of services. Why is it happening? The answer to this query is because if customer has enabled statutory modules and he has configured these ledgers for those statutory modules, then Tally will automatically map these ledgers. Here under sale of product, all those ledgers are coming which are being configured and used in VAT, CST and excise. At the same time, at the same time you can see there are some ledgers which are coming under sale of services because these ledgers have been configured for service tax. But here is some ledger that is cash ledger. This ledger is neither coming in the sale of product and nor being captured in the sale of services. The reason for the same is there are some transactions, there are two ledgers. So if customer hasn't configured them, suppose this cash ledger has been created and used in some transaction, but neither configured for because it is not being configured, so Tally can't capture it under any schedule head. That's why it is coming under ungroup. Now you see this screen, suppose this thing you get in Excel. In Excel, because everything which is in ungroup, you have to definitely move it to some schedule head. So if this page you are getting in Excel and this is the cash sales, you want to replace this cash sales from ungroup to sale of product. If you have to do it in Excel, how will you do it? We have to do it if as a customer will have to do it in Excel. Customer will select this line item, will cut it in Excel and paste here. So what do we expect from Tally? For our customer, we are providing the same experience. They can select this line item. Here something you can see move button is getting highlighted at the bottom bar. With the click of a button, it will act as a cut thing. Now, with the cursor movement, please look at this button. You can look into this button. How does it behave? So whenever it moves in ledgers, this button is disabled, and when it comes to some schedule head, it has been enabled. So, I suppose I want to paste this cash sales from ungroup to sale of product. I click on 2, and with the click of a button, you'll see the ungroup head transfer. That cash ledger has been transferred from ungroup to sale of products. This is one scenario. So this is one capability we have given in Tally. Within the same page, if you want to transfer a ledger from ungrouped part to a particular schedule head, within the same page, you can use move and to, having the function of cut and paste. But now, suppose as a customer, I have done a mistake. I wanted to pass it under some other schedule head and have pasted it under sale of product. So, I want to do, what should I do? Because it's a mistake. What we have provided, if you are doing cut, if you are doing paste and you have done a mistake, you can do undo. With the undo, the sale of catches will come back to the square gun, that is in the default position. Now the point is, when can you use the undo? I just want to highlight this thing. See, undo will only work in the case of the immediate action. If you have done cut, if you have done this, if you have pressed escape, undo won't work. Undo will work only as an immediate action. Cut, paste and undo. So this is one capability. So here what we have seen, the whole amount of 5000 has been transferred to sale of product. Then we have done the undo. It comes back to the default position. Now take another case. The another case is, suppose you haven't you have passed three entries using this statute. You have used this particular ledger for sale of product in two transactions and for sale of services in one transaction. At the same time, you haven't configured this particular ledger for any of the statutory modules. So now, while doing mapping, you can't transfer this whole amount to one of these schedule heads. What you want to do is, you want to bifurcate this particular amount on the basis of the transaction you have done of sale of product and sale of services. So as a Tally tool, as in Tally, what are we providing you? We have provided you this beautiful facility known as bifurcate. There's something which you can see at the bottom bar, control enter. Once I click on it, these classification types are coming up. So these are the five different types. Using them, you can do the mapping. So here, I'm first taking the example of bifurcate balance. With the selection of bifurcate balance, you can see at the bottom bar, Alt X, that is get value, is getting highlighted. What is the utility of this? I just click on it. With the click, you can see all those transactions. The list of transactions for this particular ledger is coming here. If I want to see what are these transactions for, I can press enter, drill down and see. So this is transaction for sale transaction for printer cartridges. Means this is something which is sale of product. Now second, I am drilling down from the second transaction. I can see again, this is also a sale of product. In case of third, when I drill down, I can see in narration, it is mentioned, this is service of printer. Means this is sale of service. What all transactions are for sale of product, not all transactions are for sale of services. Suppose, as we have drilled down from first into transaction, what my point is, as a customer, I just select these two, because I know they are the part of sale of product. There is something on the sidebar accept button, I click on it. With the click, the total amount is automatically coming here. I just press enter, list of group is coming. I select sale of product. The remaining amount, you can see the closing balance. At this point of time here in this page, showing the opening balance, debit balance, credit total and the closing balance. For this particular ledger, the credit total is 5000 and the closing balance is 5000. Even if customer want to exceed this limit, system wouldn't allow them to do. See, I'm pressing the enter, but it's not moving. So I have to give the right value so as to have the right representation. Here I just select sale of services. Now the point is, you can see here in this list of groups, only these heads are coming, and at the same time there are these, this is the parent head. The parent head is revenue from operation, and the schedule head are these. There are so many schedule heads. Why only this particular schedule heads are coming? See, here system is filtering out those schedule head which is relevant to this particular ledger. The point is, Tally understands that sales is a part of revenue. Sale is not part of expense. So, for the convenience of customer, it is filtering out only these list of schedule heads. But suppose there is a case, not in revenue from operation, but in income and in expense. So how can I do that? We have provided show all button on the sidebar. So with the click of a button, what all schedule heads are there in this for relevant to revised schedule 6 are coming up. So with the typing of one few characters, see, I want to transfer 1000 credit amount into sale of services. I just have typed 3 characters. You can see it has filtered out the relevant schedule heads. So I need not to remember the whole name of the schedule heads. Here I am just selecting sale of services, and with the click of a button the bifurcation will be done. You can see it here. I have transferred cash sales amount 4000 into sale of product. It's here. I transfer cash sales rupees 1000 into sales of services. It's here. Now the point is, I just repeat, it is only for the representation purpose. It's only for revised schedule 6 presentation. It is not at all attracting the customer default account. We just go back and see. See, you can see here the total amount is still 5000. We have to go to default account. See, in the sales account, I go to cash sales. It's coming 5000. Nothing is affecting. Whatever we will do in revised schedules is not affecting the default Tally accounts. So this is what the beauty of Tally. This is the wonderful feature which chartered accountants, which big companies were looking into, because they want to maintain their MIS report for their day-to-day purpose, as they will keep on maintaining. But only for submitting financial statement, they wanted the supporting feature. Now, this is one thing. See, when we have done cut and paste, we had the option to do undo. But here, because we haven't done cut and paste, we can't do undo. What will we do is restore. So, if somebody has done mistake while mapping, no worry. If a customer has done any mistake, no worry. They just have to select the respective line items and press restore default. So with the click on restore default, the cash sales, you can see, has come back to ungrouped revenue from operations. You can see it here now, cash sales is having 5000 amount. And it has been turned as red. Is it clear? Yeah, I know your response for this. Okay, so sure, we are moving ahead. So this is one of the main capabilities. Along with this, I'm just reading down some other expenses. And group other expenses. And there's something is interest account. When we drill down, we can see for this particular interest account, these are the debit transactions. At the same time, we can see that these are the credit transactions. What does that indicate is that for a single ledger, as a customer has maintained a single ledger named as interest account, and he has accounted both interest expense and interest income using that single ledger. But as per revised schedules requirement, the expense should get into one schedule head and income should go into another schedule head. So what is the expectation is this debit transaction total, that is this 26,000, should go into one schedule head, whereas this 9,000 should get into another schedule head. If customer would have maintained their chart of account properly, this they need not to do. But generally in SME scenario, what happens in SME customer generally, they keep maintaining only single ledger because at the end of the day they want to see the net. So for that, at the end of the day they want to see what is the interest amount I have paid or what is the interest amount I have received in net. So generally we maintain this thing, but if it is in different schedule head. So what do we expect from tally? What we expect from tally? Just press control enter. Just press control enter, select the classification type, debit, credit, transaction total. Because what we want in interest account is, we want debit transaction total should get into one schedule head, whereas credit transaction total should get into another schedule head. So here, just a minute, please inform Harsha, only one participant is there. No, so check, that's it. This is for your information. So here, in classified debit transaction, what will we select is interest account. So debit transaction total, we have to transfer under interest expense. You can see it here, what tally is showing in this screen is interest expense is a schedule 6 head. Whereas the parent head is also coming, that is finance cost. If I would have typed finance cost, it would have segregated out all these things. So that's how the smart search engine sort of thing which we have provided. Now we want to transfer all credit transactions under interest income, which is other income. So I just accepted. Here we will look into this, how the proper bifurcation has been done. How this has been done. So what we will do, we drill down from finance cost and then interest expense. Here we can see interest account is coming. So we will now see this is the debit amount. It has been captured under finance cost. And what we have transferred in credit amount is other income, interest income, and this is the credit amount. So you can see that with a click of a button, the debit transaction total has been moved to one side and credit transaction total has been moved to another side, another schedule head. So it's like we need not to worry. We just have to select that particular line item. We need to be knowing where should it go and just press control enter. So as a customer, if you are a customer, if you are a CA, it's not at all a difficult task for any one of the person to just select the particular line item and press control enter. Now we look into the inventory part. See, there is something purchase of stock in trade. Settle down from it. So whatever purchase entries, whatever purchase transaction will be made in tally will be captured under this particular purchase of stock in trade automatically, that is by default by tally. Now getting into changes in inventory. Here we will take two cases. The first case which we will take is, suppose the customer is maintaining inventory in tally. So here the first case we are taking, keeping in mind the customer is maintaining inventory in tally. So whatever inventory they maintain in tally, that will fall under stock in trade. Because in Delhi, we can't define that this particular is finished good, this particular is work in progress. We can give the particular item or group name as per our choice. But we can't tag, we can't define that this particular item belong to finished goods category, work in progress category, useful category, etc. Here, something which is mentioned in the bottom line, this is that the values are based on stock group or item wise. Means, now these values are being captured because in this particular company, we have maintained our inventory as stock group and item wise. Now, the requirement of revised Schedule 6 is whatever inventory you maintain in Delhi or wherever you maintain your inventory, you have to classify them under these heads. The inventory should be others. So, what we have provided is inventory configuration. You can see it here. So, once you click on it, there's something stock groups. I'm clicking on it. So, these all are the stock groups which we have maintained in this particular company. And by default, they all are coming under stock and trade. Now, as a customer, as a owner, business owner, I'll be better knowing this particular is a part of finished goods or stack of stock and trade. So, what do we have provided, sir? What you have to do? Now, you have to do the classification. So, what you have to do? You just do control end. See, I'm just repeating the fact that in revised Schedule 6, you just have to do the control enter to do a proper mapping wherever you are. It's as easy as it. It's very simple. You just have to do the control enter. I'm just pressing control enter and the list is coming here. I select finished goods and the accessories will become part of finished goods. This is for one line item. Now suppose I want to transfer component and computers into work in progress. I can't use control enter for more than one line item. What we can use is multi-classifier. So here I select with the click of a button, both of them will fall in the work in progress. Here we have used multi-classifier. I'm taking defective items. I select this particular line item, press control enter. Want to transfer it under loose tool. So that's how we can do the classification. Now you can see earlier the amount were coming in the stock and trade. Now a proper classification has done and the figures are coming in the finished goods, work in progress and others. This is the case where inventory has been maintained in Tally. Now I take another case where inventory is not maintained in Tally. But these things have to be disclosed because they are the part of business. So in that case, I just go to F11 features, then only accounts are being maintained in Tally, not the inventory. Then the integration of account and inventory should be made as no, because in Tally we are only maintaining the accounts. So what if account is there, we are not maintaining inventory, so generally what customer does, they get into account info, ledgers, I'm just showing you stock in trade. So this is a particular ledger. This ledger, what do they do when they don't maintain inventory in Tally with respect to that ledger? So that's how they give the figure and that's it. So for such customer, what have you provided in revised Schedule 6? You come to changes in inventory. You can see the values are based on a stock template. There is something which is a stock template getting highlighted here. Once I click on it, so here you can see here that something is a stock template. I click on it. So this is a kind of, you can give manual entry. As a business owner, I'll be better knowing what is my raw material, what is the figure should come here, what is the figure should come in work in progress, and what amount should be the part of finished goods. Because I'm not maintaining inventory and tally, I can come here and give the values. So these two values, opening balance and closing balance, will be captured from that ledger which we have just recently seen stock in trade, and rest of the bifurcation will be given by the users. It will be captured as per the classification and bifurcation provided in the stock in tablet, stock template. So that's how tally is handling inventory. So I just come here, mark it to year. So this is what the part of one more this is what the important part of profit and loss account. There is one more requirement. The requirement says any income or expense which falls under the criteria of 1% of revenue from operation. So you can see it here, this is revenue from operation. So the amount for revenue from operation is 3,065 plus 53,000. If we have to take 1% of this, it will be 3,65,000. So the requirement says any income or expense which falls under the criteria of 1% of revenue from operation or 1 lakh, whichever is higher. So in this case, we all know 3 lakh is higher, has to be disclosed as a separate line item. So if you are doing it in tally or if you are doing it in Excel, how we will do it, we just give some range, we'll give some formula, and then we have to filter it out. But that is what we don't expect from tally. What we expect from tally is the power of simplicity, click of a button. So here you can see under classify helper, with a click of a button, all those ledgers will come which fall under this particular criteria. So here you can see higher of this 1% than this. So I just select this line item, mark it as show separate. With the marking of show separate, you can see it has been moved from here and has come under ungrouped other expenses as a separate line item. See, this is not the part of ungrouped other expenses. This is a separate line item. So that's how we are addressing this requirement in tally. With the click of a button, you'll be able to see all those things. This is the part of profit and loss account. If there is any query, please raise it. Okay, move ahead. Yeah, Madhu, should we move ahead? Okay. Now we will move to balance sheet. Same with the balance sheet, we are getting into balance sheet. We have provided all tax returns. With the click of a button, the first draft for balance sheet is ready. So here you can see there is something which is coming in red, as there were some line items coming in red in profit and loss account. So why are they coming in red? We are coming in red because they are unmapped. So we have to drill down from this place and have to map them. The requirement of balance sheet is each and every asset and liability has to be bifurcated into current and non-current. So what does it mean by current? So you can see it here, Nation Traders as on 31st March 2012. So what the current is for short term. Signifies net. If by default we are taking the operating cycle of a particular business as 12 months, then whatever which fall from 31st March 2012 to 31st March 2030, so whatever which is falling in these 12 months will be considered as current. anything which will fall beyond 31st March 2013 will be considered as non-current. So this is what the requirement is. Now we'll see how are we meeting this requirement in Tally. I'm drilling down from under equity and liability. There's something with the auto finance. When we drill down from here, we can see out of this total closing balance, this amount is the part of debit and this is credit. What does it mean? This amount has been paid by the particular company, by this National Traders Private Limited. So here the amount is same. So we can assume that these are the installments, that is monthly installment, which has been paid by this particular company, and this is the whole amount which they have paid in a year. And this is some amount which they gonna pay next year. So how will we have to, now what we have to do? We have to do the bifurcation in current and non-current. For this particular thing, what we do, again, just control enter. What we select is the bifurcate balance. Now, here we have to give the balance because as a customer, as a business owner, I'll be better knowing yeah, please not know. Just let me discuss in short time. मैं ना डाइवर्ट हो जाती हूँ नहीं आप यहीं पे बैठे रहोगे क्योंकि देखो आई कैन कंटिन्यू हाँ चले जाओगे तो मैं कभी नहीं हो पाऊंगी सो हियर एज अ बिजनेस ओनर इट्स मी विल बी बेटर नोइंग व्हाट इज द अमाउंट विच आई एम गोइंग टू पे नेक्स्ट 12 मंथ आई कैन अज्यूम इफ वी विल कीप द परसेंटेज ऑफ इंटरेस्ट सेम and the rate of interest same, and we will gonna if as a business user I'm gonna pay amount at a monthly installment, it's also same for the next year. So this is the amount which I have paid this year, the same amount I'm gonna pay next year. So what I'll do, you just type the amount here, and here it should come under, and just putting it under secured loans on demand, repayable on demand from other parties. You can see it here, it's a short term borrowing. Short term means current, and if the next one which we will choose as long term will be non current. Here, Tally is automatically taking the remaining amount which we want to transfer under secured term loans from other party. So you can see the part here, it's a part of non-current liability and long-term borrowings. So once I done with it, we'll look into this, how does it come. I'm drilling down from short-term borrowing, secured, so loan repayable on demand and from other parties. So we can see here the City Auto Finance is coming. Now we see the amount of drill down which Tally has provided. So you can see here, this is short term borrowing. Under this, there is secured loan repayable on demand from other parties, and here City Auto Finance is coming. Now suppose as a customer, we have to bifurcate first into secured and then into loan payable on demand, and then we have to do the bifurcation. How much effort will it take? Whereas here, with a click of a button, Tally is doing the job. You just have to select the part, and the work which you have to do is just control enter. So you can see it here, the amount is coming. So this is one requirement. Now we move to another one. I'm drilling down from trade receivables. So under trade receivables, there's something which we have given as classify helper. So here, with the click of a button, you can see this is the amount. These are the sundry debtors. At this point, I would like to make one point. That in the revised Schedule 6, sundry debtors has been termed as trade receivables, whereas sundry creditors has been named as trade payables. So here, we drill down from trade receivables, which are sundry debtors, which have less than 6 months this amount, more than 6 months this amount. How come these amounts are coming? Reason being, the customer in this particular company, we have maintained bill wise details, That's why this particular amount has been automatically bifurcated by the system into less than 6 months and more than 6 months. And there are some entries which are coming under on account because there is no bill-wise detail maintained for these particular entries. So they are being coming under this particular line item. So what we can do, we can transfer transfer this on account to less than 6 months and more than 6 months, and then we have to bifurcate it because this is the amount which has to be come under one of them. So in tally what we have provided, you come to actual configuration. Here classify on account to and selecting less than 6 months. What amount which were there in the on account has been shifted into less than 6 months. You can see it's blank now. Here, this particular ledger, Amar Computer Peripherals, you can see that having both less than 6 months, this is the credit amount and this is the debit amount. So what does it mean by credit amount is the customer has paid in advance. So, and whereas more than 6 months debit amount means this is the amount which he is going to pay after more than 6 months. So what we have provided for this is you just to control enter, select debit credit pending amounts. It will automatically take the debit amount. You need not to worry. You can transfer into trade receivables, secured consider good which the customer is going to pay after 6 months. So we have chosen here outstanding for more than 6 months, and the credit pending amount into income received in advance. Once I selected, it's being done. You can see the classified has been marked just here. So that's how we can come here and do the bifurcation. This is for a particular line item. Suppose we want to do it for multi-line item. What can we do? I'm selecting these three line items. So you can see multi-line C5 has been getting activated. I just selected for less than 6 months and more than 6 months bifurcation. What I am choosing is trade receivables, secure consider goods for less than 6 months, and trade receivables, secure consider goods for more than 6 months. So here, again, whatever bifurcation I have done, what will it do? It will mark classified as years in front of them, which signifies that their classification, their mapping has been done by the user. So when they come here, we'll see how does they have been captured. Drilling down from outstanding for less than 6 months. See, this is just see the path. Drilling down from trade receivables, and then outstanding for less than 6 months. Secure consider goods. These are the ledgers having debit amount which has been automatically been bifurcated by the system with the help of control enter. Same for more than 6 months, we can see these ledgers debit the debit amount is coming here. Is there any doubt? Okay. So now we'll move ahead. There's something, see, whatever this is a general and common format. So whatever information will be given here will be captured in the form of figures. So there's a limitation in disclosing the required as a part of revised schedule 6. And these minimum disclosures we have captured as a part of additional information. So either you can drill down from the schedule head. There you can find this additional information column, and one by one from each and every schedule head you can drill down. Wherever these minimum disclosures required, we have given, and you can give the respective information there. If you don't want to drill down from respective schedule head, what as a customer want to do? Customer want to do from a single page. What do they expect is all the additional information with respect to all the schedule heads should come in a single page and user can disclose it in one shot. For this thing, we have provided this icon here. This icon you will also be getting in profit and loss account. If I click on it, all the additional information related to all schedule heads related to balance sheet and profit and loss account are being captured here. So you can drill down from here and get the respective information. Why we have provided them, see, these format, additional information format, are the experience as in Excel. As in Excel, we have to go into, select the cell, give the manual values. So like this, they can do it in here. So if a customer is using Tally, they need not to switch to third party tool. They can start their work from here and they can end it here too. One more thing is something that is note number. You can see here these are the note numbers starting from first. Whereas in P&L account, the note number is starting from 25. So why are they starting from first and it's starting from 25 is, see, they are in continuation. Then they start from balance sheet and will carry in profit and loss account. So what series as a customer want to use, they'll use. If they want to use a numeric series 1, 2, 3, 4, they can use. They want to use alphanumeric series, they can use. Or they want to use the Roman series, they can use. Tally has provided the flexibility to use any kind of series that the customer wants. It is a customer choice to use any of the series. Now at the same time, you can see something notes has given here. These are known as narrative description to notes. This is something which are kind of policies of a particular company which they want to disclose with their financial statement. They can come here, either they can type, or else if they want to copy it from Word document, they can write in Word document, copy from the Word document, and can paste in this particular blog. So in this particular blog, how will they paste it in Tally? Control Alt V. The limit for this particular narrative description to note are 2000 characters. Still 2000 characters they can capture here. So whatever they'll capture will be captured here. Either they can capture it in one shot or else they can drill down from the schedule head. There is also note button is given. They can capture here too. So once they capture here, it will get reflected as a part of notes. There's something that is compare company which we have given. What is this compare company is? See, as per the requirement for current year, they have to submit revised schedule 6. But along with this, they have to also compare with the previous year. So for doing this, they have to do two work. One, they have to map current year, and the second one, they have to map previous year. So what we want, what our customer expects from Tally is simplicity, and that is what we have provided here. We don't need to do it twice. If there are common ledgers, if there are common groups, we just compare the company with comparing company. They can select the previous year company, and with the comparing company, it will automatically map the common ledger. So this is what the beauty of Tally, which is reducing the effort, reducing the time, also the cost of the particular company. So this is one case where both companies are similar, means consecutive companies. There's a national trade of 10, 11, 11, 12. Currently, year they have maintained. They want to compare the next year, 12, 13. They can do like this. But suppose there's a CA who is having two customers. Both the customers are into trading. So, because they are in the same line of business, they might be having same schedule heads. So, for that, once we'll be done with one particular company schedule mapping and all, he need not to do it for another. What we have provided here, something is copy configuration. So I just come here, you can see this is the copy classification. With the click of copy classifier, it will tell if they want to copy from which company. So I want to copy it from 11-12. Here I am selecting the financial year as 11-12. So with the click is what the beauty of Tally. This is what simplicity we have provided in Tally, that whenever you are going to meet any customer or CA, you just have to tell about the control enter, just have to tell about the copy pasting. So this, where they have to transfer, how will they do, that's not a big concern because this is something domain specific. Is there any doubt? So how do you find it? What is your feeling regarding this particular tool? Because when you're going to meet customer, when you will go and meet CAs, so it's you who has to carry it on. So we want to get your feedback about regarding this. Hello. Now, Midhun ji, I just want to know one thing. Because you are a partner, haven't you got the data, demo data? You might have got some CD, engagement CD, where there might be demo data. If not, please drop me your ID, I'll mail it to you. Please drop me your mail ID, I'll mail the demo data to you. Is it fine? Yeah, so please mail me your ID. So please drop me your ID here itself in chat. I'll mail you demo data. Okay, thank you. Yeah, Gulshan ji, I'm here. So what we have done, we have just went through revised schedule 6. Now we'll see what new announcement we have taken in, we have given in release 3.6 regarding audit tool. So for the same, what I'm doing, I'm moving to audit and compliance menu. Here I'm getting into audit and analysis. Under audit and analysis, I'm getting into other analysis. And these things are the new one, new feature, new announcement which we have provided in release 3.6. One is external confirmation and another is account reconciliation. The first one will take the external confirmation. So what does third party confirmation is? Suppose this company is National Traders Private Limited. This company has done business with some other company. We can name that some other company as these are the companies you can see here. Suppose the other companies are my computer peripherals. So because their business is of this amount, and CA want to get the confirmation from this party that yes, the business between National Traders and my computer peripherals is of 41,235. So this is what the confirmation CA want to take. So this is something which is in high demand, which we have provided in Tally. So how will we move on it? We just have to, if as a CA, they just have to select this particular line item by pressing the space bar. With the pressing the space bar, you can see something is getting highlighted. You just look at the sidebar. Something is getting highlighted and getting enabled and disabled. This is marked for information. So once it is getting highlighted, we select it. So the Markov Fund Commission, it has been turned off. It means as a CA, she has asked for this particular the third party confirmation from this particular party. The party is on a computer peripherals. Now we consider the remote scenario where CA is doing the audit. He want to get the confirmation from this third party. At the same time, client can also access this data. So how will client come to know that for which letter CA has asked for the confirmation? For this, client has to move into display. Please focus on this path. You will get the path here, display, and then they will go to statement of accounts, and then account audit and compliance info, start audit info. Here it shows external confirmation. When they drill down, you can see that these are the ledgers among computer peripheral for which the CA has asked for the confirmation. So what will the user do? The user will select this particular line item using the space bar. With the space bar, this line item has been selected. Same, you can see the behavior. I can click on mark request sent as yes. I'm just giving remarks, send the confirmation through courier. So once the mark says yes, it will ask, do you want to print it or export it? Just put it as yes. This is for the printing thing. It is asking, do you want to print as yes or no? They want to export it, they have to use alti. So here for printing, I use backspace. It is asking me, do you want to print the confirmation letter along with the statement of accounts? Means whatever the accounts part, for whatever accounts there, in nation radar books of accounts for Amar computer peripherals, will also get printed with the confirmation letter. So this is the part which is the part of customer. So customer will come here, customer will print the confirmation letter, customer will print the confirmation letter along with the statement of accounts. So it's the work of customer to give the firm address, name of chartered accountant, their address and place to the third party, so that third party will directly send the confirmation to CA rather than contacting the client. You can see here the confirmation letter. See, this is a common format which has been used by, which we have got by meeting CAs and all. So this is commonly used thing. And here you can see the letter has been printed along with the statement of accounts. So here in National Trader Books of Accounts, the statement of account of former computer peripherals has also been getting printed. So once this is done, what will CA look at your site? We'll come to audit and compliance. Audit and analysis, other analysis, and external confirmation. So once they come here, they can see this for this particular ledger, they have asked for the confirmation, and the client has sent some request, and the client has given this remarks to the third party. So once third party will get the confirmation letter by mail or by post, whatever, third party will contact the CA and confirm the same. So CA can come here, select this line item using the space bar. So with the space bar selection, we'll select confirm balance. You can see it here. So with the confirm balance, they'll give the amount. Suppose he has confirmed 30,000 balance after interacting with Amber computer peripherals. And just give some remarks, confirmed. So whatever amount he has asked for the confirmation, whatever amount is confirmed, if there is any difference, it's been reflecting here. So this is the scenario where CA can do the get the third party confirmation using PADI. There's some another thing, that is account reconciliation. Now this is something which is also useful for the big companies when the companies are having internal auditors. The companies are having a proper account department, finance manager and all. So what they can do is, they can do the account reconciliation. So under account reconciliation, you can see the account reconciliation, the list of sundry debtors and creditors of national traders are coming. So I take the example, suppose there are two companies, I'm loading Horizon System. And we just assume that these two companies, Nation Trader is HO, that is head office, whereas Horizon System is branch office. And as an internal auditor, I am having both the data with me. Or as an accountant, I am having both the data with me. Now, with the periodical analysis and thing, you want to check how the we want to reconcile the accounts of HO with RO. So I come here in National Trader Books of Account, that is the head office books of account, and looking for the ledger of the branch office, which I took it here as Horizon System. I press enter. It will ask me, do I want to compare by loading ledger or by loading transaction, as company is there on my system. So I can load the ledger from the data. So I can select loading ledger, list of company, Horizon System. So in Horizon System, what the scenario is, which National Trader Books of Account we are taking, the ledger name will be Horizon System. Same as we are taking Horizon System Books of Account, ledger name will be National Trader. So here, you can see here it has compared books of Horizon System with National Trader. And they can see that unreconciled, these are the transactions and for the for system. See, the beauty of Tally is that what they have done, it has segregated all the transactions which can be reconciled and which can't. So what are we doing here? You can see here, just a minute. So how can Tally has understand that these can be reconciled? So on the basis of the amount, on the basis of the transaction type, and on the basis of the date, it has segregated the amount. So what will, if as a CA I come here, I can see that sales voucher can be reconciled with the purchase voucher. In case of sales voucher entries in one company, then another company will definitely have purchase voucher entry. I just select using the space bar and do accept reconciliation, and it will get reconciled. You can see it here, it's coming with reconciliation. So that's how this can be done. And suppose I just take another example, I get into Horizon System. Suppose this is the case, your system has segregated. Take another case, this sales amount, that is 1,12,736, this amount, sales voucher has been passed in Horizon System books of account, but for this particular sale, the purchase entry are being passed in two different installments. Purchase has been done in two different installments, but this is the amount. So system can't understand because amount is not same, but if as a user I want to reconcile it, what will I do? First, by pressing enter, I can see the voucher. You can see it here. I can see the voucher. I'm sorry. See, by pressing enter, I can see the voucher. And this is the entry which has been done. Now, after looking into the voucher, I would like to reconcile it. There's something reconcile in bottom bar. I click on it. So, with the click of a button, it will give me all those entries which I can reconcile against this particular entry. So I select those entries which can be reconciled against it. Press enter. Give the remarks. And it can be reconciled. Now you can see that 1,12,000 which were earlier here in unreconciled has been moved from this portion to this portion. And reconciled has been marked as years in front of this particular line item. So that's how bill by bill or transaction by transaction they can do reconciliation using Tally. So this is some feature which is helpful for both for auditor as well as for those clients who are having big businesses, having branch offices, head offices, and proper setup for finance department, where their manager can use this feature. Now we move to tax audit. So what is any tax audit? See, this is Form 3CD. So in Tally, we have captured all 32 clauses, both financial and non-financial. So it will vary with the company whether they are applicable for a particular company or not. They can come here, select that particular line item and update the same that yes, it's applicable or not. And once they have maintained this form 3CD that this is what is applicable and this is what is not, they can copy this form 3CD from this particular year to another year. So for which we have provided this copy form option. So in Tally, what we have provided is we have some very beautiful enhancement we have done this time. Earlier what happened? Whenever we went to CS, we showcase our tool to them, and it was like it's a wonderful tool, so they really praise it. So this was coming like this. You can see it here. So because in our demo data we have maintained all the modules, be it the VAT, be it the tax. So everything is all the vouchers entries are coming in front of our vouchers numbers are being captured properly. But suppose that when it's the time comes of those data where none of the statutory modules is being compliant in time. So what is the situation of demo data is like this. So this was the situation. So all the taxation part, the MB, the TDS, service tax, that will be coming blank. Only the clause 17 and clause 18, if they have specified some specific person, if they have made any amount payment transaction in cash more than 20,000, that would be captured here. And rest things will be blank. So even if we want to do the audit, they can't. So what we have provided this time, we have provided something that is very. They can come here and see through verification of vouchers, which is all such things will be captured here. So by coming here, they can tag this particular ledger to any clause. So now you can see a link. So with the verification of voucher, they are preparing annexures, which are automatically generation of annexures. There will be preparation of reports, which will definitely gonna help them filling form CCD. Now we'll look how these reports will get generated. So here none of the statutory module is being maintained. So they can select national headers, click on it. They select one particular line item. Suppose I want it linked with clause 14. I want to audit it, get some remarks. So once I have done the audit, you can see here this clause is reflecting here. And there's number of the audited thing. So that's how suppose they have done for audit. So how will it help them to fill the form 3CD? And getting into clause 14, there's something that is 44AB audit. Once I click on it, whatever thing I have, there's a thing that Gulshinji want it to be repeated once. Yeah, sure. Once I finish it, I repeat it. Sure, I'll do it once again. So what you can see here, once it comes here, and the 14th clause, whatever verification at the time of verifying the vouchers, whatever ledgers have been tagged to a particular clause, so will be reflected here. So this national traders we tag to the clause 14. So it's coming here. I take another example. I'm just repeating it. See this, I'll repeat it. This is the case where none of the statutory module, either service tax, VAT or TDS has been maintained in this particular tally. There is so whatever transaction which has been done, all these things are being captured under this verification of vouchers. So as an auditor, they need not to be dependent on that their client has used a particular statutory module or not. They can come here and do the audit. So how can they do? So whatever transaction has been passed will be captured in this verification of voucher. I just drill down. These are the group. drill down further. So this is a transaction. Now I can look into this transaction and get to know with which particular clause I can tag it. As an auditor, I'll be better knowing which particular clause this particular transaction should be linked with. So I just press enter. It will give me a list of clauses with which I can tag this particular ledger. So suppose I'm selecting 17A. So the tagging is done. Now I want to audit it. Now I've done auditing. So here what I have done, see 44AB audit. I have done here 44AB audit, and simultaneously I have make a report. That is, this particular clause, this particular ledger is linked with this particular clause. Because what happens, once auditors are done with 44AB audit, they'll have to fill Form 3CD as per the audit which they have done. So in that case, we don't want them to again go back to 44AB audit documents and see what they have done, because this is a huge data. What we want, they can come to this particular clause. Just come here, there is something 44AB order which we have provided. So once they click on it, I just get into wrong clause and getting into clause 17A. So once they click on it, all text, that is 44AB order, this is the voucher which I have tagged in 44. So now we need not to get into 44AB order and see, because for filling this information, they need to have whatever they have done audit. So here we are saving their time is to come out and relook into the document. They can just see here the filter report. The filter report, the report which is linked to this particular clause, they can see into it and take the proper decision. So this will help them to fill this information. Is it clear, sir? Vishanji, is it clear? Okay, so this is the case when we are not maintaining a statutory module in Delhi. Now there is another company where every module is being maintained perfectly. So you can see it here. So everything is coming. Their rule is maintaining. That's why clause 16 having this number of vouchers. We have maintained service tax that. We are having TDS. So so these things are coming here. Now what we have provided, so these are the annexures. There are some of the annexures which are getting refilled. So what actually they have to do, they have to serve you 44AB audit. Then by relooking into those documents, they come here in Form 3CD, they prepare the annexure, fill the details. So it is in 44AB. Drill down from there, tag that particular ledger to a particular clause. So when they come into Form 3CD to their respective clause, the report will be ready. Now we'll see. Suppose now we are getting into clause 17A2M. This is a scenario. Now I haven't tagged a single voucher to clause 17A2M. So then I go to 44AB order, it will show it like this. So what we have provided here, I just drill down from A2M. There is something business promotion expenses. Suppose as an auditor, when I came across this transaction, I got to know that though it is being marked as a business promotion expenses, but actually this is the amount which has been given to a political party for their advertisement. So now, being an auditor, it's my duty to report this particular amount, to report this particular transaction. So I need to tag it to the respective clause. So what we have to provide it, some same. This is a line item, I just press enter. I select here 17C, that is expenditure on advertisement published by a political party to be reported. ABC is the political party name. Audit it. So that's how it has been done. So what tally is providing you? See, we come to 17C. Click on annexure. The annexure is ready. See, while doing, because customer has maintained all the things properly, so while doing audit, the annexures are getting ready. So once as an auditor will come here, he can type it as per annexure and the annexure is already ready. So that's how we have simplified his job. Is it clear? Participants, please do let me know, is it clear? If not, I will take it once again. Please respond on chat. Okay, thank you. So this is what is very important from the background of CA and the big companies. Now we take something which we can offer when we are meeting our SME customers. See, for SME customer, what is important? They just want to see their day-to-day business using MIS report. And also, what is important is for them is just the data, their data should be clean up, there shouldn't be any redundant data and all. So, whenever anyone of us is going to meet such customer, what will we tell them? Sir, you tell them from audit and analysis. There's something compare company. And selecting national credit 10-11. So, here why I'm selecting 10-11 is, for current year, there's the audited books of account is previous year. So when they come, what is the rise, what is the increase, how much is the decrease in this current year. So yeah, we just take a glance of it, what we can meet and tell the customer. That is verification of chart of accounts. When they drill down, you can see there is something not used. So these are the ledger which neither use in 11-12 nor use in 10-11. So the point is, then as a owner I come here, it is my concern, why have I created it? If I am going to use it for the next year, I can keep it with them, with my name. If not, then maybe possible that I have done duplication of entries. I created one ledger as general expense. And again, I created another ledger as general expenses. So just expense and expenses, they make it two ledgers. One entry I have done the entry, and another ledger is making my data redundant. So I can come here and delete the particular ledger. Same way, as a business owner, it will be my choice that I want to see what all the ledgers which I use in current year. So these are all ledgers which we have used only in current year. They were neither created in previous year nor used. So if we want to see it grow files, we can come to F4. The customer want to see what are his sundry creditors, which all are the suppliers, which as a business owner I've been knowing that these are the suppliers which I have done business this year. And they are my new suppliers. So I can come here and see that these are my new supplier with whom we have done business this year. So that's how this report will be helpful from the perspective of a business owner. Now there's something that is verification of stock items. We are maintaining inventory in tally. So as a customer, I need to see is there any negative stock. So if there any, then I need to look into it. So I just get into particular stock item and would like to see the daily break. So here with a click of a button, it will show the list of all those negative stock items as per day wise. I can come here and see it. See, verification of balances is a very important thing as a previous, like the closing balance of the previous year should be equal to the opening balance of the current year. So if there's differences coming, this is something either as a business owner, I passed on the entry and sorted that now, or else when the CA will come to audit my account, he will find this thing and ask for the clarification. So in such situation, I should be ready with the answers. So that's how the steward will help the owner. So when you come here, they will see that there's something which is exceptions. So once I click on it, so these all are the rows having this much as the opening balance, this much as the closing balance, and this is what the difference is. If they want to see it ledger-wise, we have provided them as price ledger-wise. So with ledger-wise, they can see what is the opening balance for current year, closing balance in the previous year, and how much the difference is coming. Same as in business, their concern is to get to know, is there any cash which is having negative balance. If the cash is negative, it is a big concern. So they can come here and see if any cash is negative. So anything which is coming in red is showing that the cash is in negative. Another thing which we do not take is pending documents. So as a business owner, its concern is to know what all my receivables are. So here under receivables, you can see there are few sundry creditors too. So what are these sundry creditors are? These sundry creditors are coming under receivables because they are those supplier whom as a business we have paid in advance. So that's why they are part of exception, so they are coming under red. So and suppose there is something which we have provided as age wise. So when we click on assets age wise, we can see 18 by due date. You can give number of days here as per my choice, and it will bifurcate the pending amount into less than 180 days and more than 180 days. So that's how the bifurcation can be seen for these receivables. Same is with the payables. See in the periodic payments, I'm selecting indirect expenses. Office rent. See here, this is a list of ledgers which are falling under the group of indirect expense. So once I click on it, it will show me the list of groups which are there in my chart of accounts. I'm selecting here indirect expense. It will show me the list of ledgers which are related to this particular group, because as a business owner, I will be better knowing which particular ledger is part of the periodic payment and receipt. I'll be knowing that this particular rent I'm paying periodically, monthly, half-yearly, annually, something like that. So here I'm choosing selecting office rent. You can see office rent is coming here. So with the space bar, I'm selecting it. And here something is FIF update. So with the click of a button, it will be marked as yes. So I come to audit and analysis, periodic payment and receipt. And you can see audit rent is coming. So this audit rent was something which was there in 11-12, which is there in 10-11. Now as a customer, I can come here and look into the variance. So if I want to see the further yearly, year-wise, their month-wise, whatever we have paid, they can come here and look into the till entry level they can drill down. Now there is something which is repeated transactions. So see for this particular ledger, Center Summer, there are two repeated transactions. So these are the transaction of the sales where the amount is same, voucher type is same, and the date is same. So what does it reflecting? It may be a reason that these are two transactions, or it may be a reason that this is a duplication of entry. The case is that accountant, he got to know by lunch that there is some entry he has to pass, and he has passed it. When he came back from lunch, he just forget that he has passed this entry, and he redo the entry. So this may be a case that a duplication of work has been done. So they can come here and look into this, what all things has been duplicated or not. In actual configuration, we have provided some combination. The combination work on same different thing. What are this is? See, it shows that the same party, same value, but the date is different. That it has to ignore. Say it goes like this. Show repeated transaction ignoring date, having same party, same value, ignoring party, having same date and value, ignoring value, having same party and date. So if I choose it, I'm just ignoring party, we look for those transactions having same date and same value equal to, I just accept it. So you can see a date price. This is the amount. There are three vouchers who are having duplication of entries. So that's how, as a business owner, I can come here and look into this and keep my books of account ready prior audit. So that is what the concept of audit ready is. We have something in other analysis as holiday transactions on holiday. So if we drill down from here, this is something holiday configuration. So here with the, see it's my business, so I it's me only, I'll be better knowing whether it's a part of which one is my weekly day. I want to have a weekly day off on Sunday and Tuesday. So I can select here. These are the national holidays. So we can come here and see what all transactions have been made on these particular holidays. If they only want to see the national holidays, want to leave the weekly off, so they can come to the range, sorry, they can come to F12 configuration. This is something show weekly off, not applicable, and the rest things will come. So the point is, if somebody will come to know that on Labor Day, that is May Day, so many transactions have been done by this particular party. कुछ गलत बोल रही हूँ मैं. अच्छा, तो ऑन लेबर डे दिस मेनी ट्रांजेक्शन हैज बीन डन इन दिस पर्टिकुलर कंपनी. सो मे बी द रीजन दैट इफ इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट वुड कम टू नो, सो दे मे एज पर द क्लेरिफिकेशन इन ऑल, सो इट्स बेटर दैट बीइंग अ ओनर शुड बी अवेयर ऑफ ऑल सच थिंग्स. सो दैट्स हाउ, सी दीज आर सच रिपोर्ट in default tally. As a owner, I want to search, as a user, I want to search, I can't. But audit tool will, with a click of a button, will throw such reports, which are exceptional reports and which will definitely gonna help the customer to keep their books of account ready prior audit and clean up their data. In tax audit, as a part of customer, we have provided that. In 44AB, there is something clause 17H. So, what does clause 17H say? That amount 20,000 the payment amount 20,000 in cash and more is being disallowed. It's not allowed. Even if it has been done, then this will be disallowed and won't become the part of income tax. So, suppose as a business owner, I got to know that 40,000 cash payment has been done. And that's a part of expense. And this is something which is not being granted in income tax. Then what is the utility of doing this? There may be an urgency that they have done it. If not, then be a business owner, I'd be better aware of this. So what we have provided this report that with the click of a button, we'll be able to see all those transactions which has been done in more than 20,000. They can come here. With the press enter and can see the transactions regarding this regarding these particular ledger. They can get into particular ledger and can see the transactions. So that's how they can be aware what actually going on in their business and can do the same, can do the relevant work. So participant, this is all about in audit tool. We just want to we would like to take the queries. If there are any query, please write on chat. And if not, then please share your feedback. They'll start by their own. It's at 4:30. they are not asking queries, no? So, maza nahi aa raha. Seriously, it's boring. Do you want it here? Have you had to? Have you been? Not paying attention. नहीं वो तो मुझे लग गया था बीच बीच में जब आप लोग कुछ कर रहे थे then I decided next time इन दोनों को साथ नहीं बैठाऊंगी मैं अब उठाऊंगी दोनों चले जाओ कहीं और let me do my work क्या क्या शॉप है just to finish it off otherwise please I'm gonna na aapko hata rahi hu can't hear you okay bolna padega yeah dear all we have done with our part so if any query is there please write it on chat if not then please share your feedback please ask any query if it's there if not please share your feedback Hello Mithun ji, can you hear me now? Hello Mithun ji, can you hear me now? Am I audible? Participants, please share your feedback. Not able to hear you. So, main kya karun? Participant, if it's done, then if there's no query, then we will wind up the session. participants, there's no query, then we would like to wind up the session. Kindly share your feedback if you want to. If Partner Bora, I'll check it down demo data and contact you if the error is any query. Dear Partner, Mithunji, I'll forward you the demo data. And if you have any query, the first contact thing for the partners is our partner support portal. Partner support, that is BAP@ That is partner.support@alisolution.com and you can call them up. If you have any query in this session, so please let me know. I just asked for the last time that because I'm not getting response from the clients, should we wind up the session? Okay, thank you. We are going to wind up our session. Thanks for being part of this session. Thank you.
Thank you.